What I wouldn't give for a good night's sleep. Zulf had difficulty telling me his story. Having heard it, I could understand why. Day of Zulf's life. There in the Hanging Gardens, he aimed to throw it all away. First time Zulf had nothing to lose. He was born to a simple Ura couple who didn't last long before plague took him. Stealing from a Ceylonian missionary living there. Got sloppy with his thieving hands. The missionary caught him, but didn't rat him out. Instead, he offered to take him in. Missionary raised Zulf like a gentleman, like he was his own son. Taught him theology, history, and mercy. the missionary passed away, Zulf promised to continue his work to bring about a lasting peace between the Ura and Ceylandia. Zulf started teaching the missionaries wisdom to any Ura who would listen, and listen they did. Advocated tolerance, and argued that the Ura should atone for the war. He believed the city had much to teach his people. Zulf felt he could only do so much in the Tassel terminals. He needed Ceylandia to know the Ura had changed. Thank you. decided to do what the missionary did many years before. He left the city of his youth to brave a savage land. Journey was hard, but he knew how to fend for himself. And then at last, Zulf saw the rippling walls on the horizon. He endeared himself to city folk straight away, and in turn he fell in love with the city and its people, one in particular. This young lady was fascinated by the Ura, but she never met anyone like Zulf. She told him she knew all the city's best-kept secrets. Gardens was their favorite spot. It was there that Zulf clasped her hands and proposed in proper Ceylonian style. Celebrated with his friends long into the night. Joy and revelry like he'd never seen. Too bad he couldn't remember it all. up alone underground inside the Ur-Ceylandian War Memorial, built like an Uriden. But something was wrong. From that hole in the ground into a waking nightmare. Everything that wasn't gone was twisted upside down. Few faces he saw on the street stared back at him with gray and vacant eyes. wife-to-be asleep inside her home, but when he reached out to her, she joined with all the ashes in the sky. So Zulf returned the way he proposed in the Hanging Gardens, and there he stood, as if the gods would answer him. The kid's gonna be okay. As for that man, who knows? Come on.